Hello. I only have 5 minutes to talk, or less. I went and got groceries, and they're falling all over this car. I'm driving a different car, if you couldn't tell. I haven't done my hair. I just threw it all back. And here's what I was going to say. Yesterday, my mom invited me to go to lunch. She wanted to go to Cracker Barrel. It was about 1 or 2 in the afternoon, so she had gotten up late and had a late start to her day and was hungry and wanted to invite me out to lunch. Of course, she's not inviting the whole family. That's an expensive event to do that all the time. She just doesn't want to go out to eat alone, and she just moved up here. So she used to live 2 hours away. Now she's 6 miles away from me. And this event of her moving up here is already drastic of enough of a change for me and my husband, who has some insecurities about me going out with my mom. He feels uncomfortable with the whole thing. He's not very comfortable with me hanging out with her all the time. But she's my mom, and shaking, wasn't it? She's my mom, and he knows that there's nothing much that he can do about her being in my life. He knows that I'm gonna want to see her, so he keeps me on a short leash, if that's even anywhere near what you call normal. My life as a codependent wife whose husband is probably autistic in an Asperger sort of way, I can understand he has a hard time with change. He has a hard time with adjusting to new things, to a new routine. And having things sprung on him at the last minute, such as my mom wants to take me to lunch, is already hard enough alone. But then he gets in his insecurities and his rigidity, thinking that I'm going to cheat on him and I'm going to run off with another man, or my mom's going to set me up with somebody to... he has a really imaginative mind, and he can think of the worst case scenarios instead of just appreciating that, dude, I just want to go to lunch with my mom. So that's kind of where I'm at with what I deal with on a day-to-day basis when it comes to things out of the ordinary. The part that freaked me out yesterday was that he assumed it was the third time that I'd gone out with my mom, and yesterday would have been the fourth time. I'd been out 3 other times with her, and I'm like, that's not true. I've only been out with her once on Mother's Day. She's only lived here for 2 or 3 weeks now, and I've only been out with her once without the family, and that was on Mother's Day. And he didn't buy it, but I was able to pull up my Google history and prove to him that, look at my timeline. It says I go to work. It says I come home. It goes I go to work. It goes I go home. He's imagining even the facts. His memory is not heightened because of his autism. It's actually a normal memory clouded by his fears and insecurities. And I cried about it yesterday. I had an emotional meltdown. That how could you expect me to be flexible and understanding when your memory isn't even working properly? That just tells you how bad it is. That tells you how bad your insecurities are if you can't even remember actual facts. He said, well, you went out with her on a Friday night. I'm like, no, I didn't. I went out with her one time on a Sunday on Mother's Day. I didn't go out with anybody on a Friday night. So I'm grabbing the groceries right now. Going to go inside. Hope you enjoyed your 5 minutes or less. Wife of an autism. Well, wife of an Aspie. Vlog series. Alright, talk to you later. Peace.